Okay, we're here at one of the Memorial Weekend events, which is the Meat Pie Supper at the Congregational Christian Church, which has been going on for a little while. And Pastor Cheryl Ryder, can you give me a little history of what you've done here with the Meat Pie Supper over the years?
Well, when we started, it was before the coronavirus, right? So that's kind of changed things. And we have done really wonderful, $3,000 worth of gift cards in the previous years that we've been able. Last year, we did takeout only, again, because of COVID. And we're hoping that this year we can bring things back up again, bring people back together again.
Because you got some good food here for people to eat today.
Yes, thanks to Hartley's, we do.
Can you tell me about the volunteers you have working here in the kitchen?
Well, who we have are almost all members of the church right now. Let me just turn my head for 1 second. All members of the church right now. But I would be amiss if I did not lift up Karen Russo specifically, who is the point person who has led this event. But I have a combination of people back there who are longtime members, been here for years and years and years, and some are brand new members who just joined us last year. So it's a wonderful group. And sitting around the tables, there are also members of our church as well as community who are veterans. And so it's wonderful to be able to support them.
How many suppers do you think you're going to serve today?
That is a good question, and I really don't know the answer.
Well, in the past, how many?
Karen has the answer to that one, not me. But I would say close to 100. I mean, that's what we do. I know they've got takeouts as well as people in, so it's going both ways.
Rebecca, this is your first Meat Pie Supper in Somerset for Memorial Day weekend. What do you think of their operation?
This is pretty awesome, actually.
So the money that's raised for this goes to help veterans in need in Somerset. Can you tell me a little what will be done with the money?
Sure. So our plan is to buy gift cards, like for Stop and Shop, grocery gift cards. Many people don't know within the community that we do have a lot of low-income veterans, surviving widows and family members that are on a very tight budget. And any support that we can give them would be much appreciated.
Do we have a lot of those types of veterans?
We do. We have quite a bit.
We have a lot of senior citizens.
We do.
Probably veterans as well.
Can I add to that, that it was also a wonderful way for Jessica to, having just come to Somerset, to get to know some of us and some of the veterans around town and how things work a little bit. Mm-hmm. So hopefully it helps in that matter too.
Yeah.
How many years has this been going on now?
Cindy, how many years have we been doing this now? 6 years. There we go. Six-ish.
This was started by Ed Miranda, who was doing this over in Swansea before he came here and started another great fundraiser here. Can you say a little something about him?
About Ed? Oh my goodness, what an amazing man. Giving everything he did. He not only put on the dinners, he did all the footwork to help raise the money from the local community, the businesses, the food, he did everything. It just was amazing. He really, really was amazing. And the fact that to start something intentionally to hopefully move on, to help future generations as we move, I think it's awesome. And that just speaks to the person he was.
Okay, thanks for answering my questions.
Thank you.
Each and every one of you for coming out and lining the streets in honor of our fallen and remembering them on this very special day. I feel very welcomed coming into the town of Somerset. You had an amazing turnout and you really show that you care about your veterans. So it's really awesome and I appreciate it. But today really isn't about us. Today is a day that we remember those brave men and women who paid that ultimate sacrifice for their nation's freedom. For each of these men and women, we owe them and their families the highest regard, respect, honor, by assuring them every single year that we do this parade and this ceremony, and that their sacrifice will never be forgotten. We will always remember them and honor them on Memorial Day. At this time, I'm going to ask the fire guard, the honor guard, to get ready for the Pledge of Allegiance. Can you please remove your baseball hats to prepare for Pledge of Allegiance? I pledge of allegiance to the flag of the United States of America, to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, liberty, and justice for all. This is going to be followed by the national anthem sung by Miss Fall River 2022, Lindsay Aruda. Did I mess that up?
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, for the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave for the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Wonderful. At this time, I'm going to ask our Grand Marshal Walter come up, and we're going to do the wreath ceremony. Do you think you can go up there, or do you want to say a few words first? All right, he's going to say a few words.
Just bear with me because of my voice. A short time ago, we were at the World War I monument on Riverside Avenue. You know, there are monuments like this throughout the country in every state. However, the greatest tribute to our fallen veterans is not some stone or the structure. It's a legacy. It's something that is a far outshines a polished piece of granite. And that legacy is freedom. I want to thank Rebecca Jennings and the Veterans Council for inviting me this morning. Thank you.
Thank you so much. At this time, we ask that the Board of Selectmen Chairman of the Board, Alan Smith, come up and say a few words, please.
Thank you, Rebecca. To all present, our veterans and families of veterans, especially those who lost loved ones in service to our country, I'm grateful to be the messenger bringing best wishes on behalf of members of the Board of Selectmen and a grateful town. It is a poignant fact that a recent survey found that only 25% of Americans knew the meaning of Memorial Day. Memorial Day isn't the official start of summer or the day the beaches open for the season. Memorial Day is previously known as Decoration Day. It's a day that General John A. Logan in 1868 proclaimed to be observed annually and nationwide as a day to decorate the graves of veterans lost during wars. In 1971, Congress passed the Uniform Monday Holiday Act and established that the last Monday in May was to be observed as Memorial Day. There are easily more than a million stories of brave men and women who have made the ultimate sacrifice for freedoms that we enjoy every day. How many of those in attendance today know why the Southern Bridge that connects Somerset and Fall River is named the Charles Braga Jr. Memorial Bridge? Charles was from Fall River and was too young to enlist in the Navy without parental consent, so he had to badger his father for days to get him to give permission to enlist. By the age of 22, Charles was a yeoman second class in the USS Pennsylvania. He worked as a secretary in the ship's executive office. By October of 1941, he was training to become a Navy pilot and finished with a 3.99 average in a battery of tests. On the morning of December 7th, 1941, he did some chores before the attack started. One of the bombs that dropped by the Japanese aircraft exploded in the USS Pennsylvania just as Charles was passing through that spot. Charles' body was never found. The bike path along Veterans Memorial Bridge is named in honor of Army Private Michael Bluthout, who's the son of Somerset residents. After graduating from Diamond High School, he enlisted in the Army and was assigned to the 1st Squadron, 67th Armored Battalion, 2nd Brigade Combat Team, 4th Infantry Division of Fort Hood, Texas. At just 19 years old, he lost his life in 2006 while serving our country during Operation Iraqi Freedom. An improvised explosive device detonated next to the Humvee that he was in. How many of us take a moment to thank Navy Yeoman Second Class Charles Braga or Army Private Michael Blouth for their service as we cross over those bridges each day? For those that have never served, it's difficult for us to fathom the bravery and courage it takes to leave your family and friends, to leave what is comfortable and safe, and venture to the unknown. What level of risk will you encounter? Why do so many brave men and women enlist? For most, they do it out of a sense of service for others, sense of duty, and love of the country. Unfortunately, not all those who leave home to serve return. Many lay in our nation's cemeteries, having given their lives to protect our way of life. As a nation, we choose one day to pay our respects to those that have fallen. But shouldn't every day really be Memorial Day? While every day can't be Memorial Day, I ask that you spend some time today honoring those that have given their life in service to the country. Visit one of our cemeteries that are decorated with American flags and spend some time reading the markers. Go online and do some research into those who lost their lives in the service of our country. It is not said often enough, but please know that the brave men and women who give the ultimate sacrifice are in our thoughts and prayers, always and never forgotten.
So much, sir. I appreciate it. At this time, I have asked, it's a little change in the program. I have actually asked Miss Fall River of 2022, Lindsay Arada, to come up and say a few words. Afterwards, she's going to sing God Bless America.
I would just like to thank you all for coming and celebrating and honoring those that have given their lives to protect our country. I come from a long line of veterans and appreciate all that our service members have done and continue to do to keep us safe. Today is the day to remember, reflect, and appreciate all of their sacrifices so that we can be free. I'm extremely humbled to be honoring all of those brave service members who paid the ultimate sacrifice for our country. It is a debt we can never repay. So thank you all again for celebrating with us. And as I said earlier, every day should be Memorial Day. So remember to think about where your freedoms came from and honor those who gave their lives. Thank you so much.
Before we do the closing prayer, I want to especially thank our honor guard that came out. I know it was very hot today, but I certainly appreciate your ability to come and truly honor those fallen and our veterans. And it means a lot to have you guys and to hold those colors high, and I appreciate it. So at this time, I'm going to ask Chaplain Bradford Barco to come up and say a few words for the closing prayer. That will be followed by the honor guard and the volley and taps. Please remain standing because colors will need to be exited.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Heavenly Father, we thank you for having brought us together today to pay tribute to those who lost their lives defending our nation. May their souls live on in your gracious presence, and may they experience the full measure of your love and mercy. We also ask that you guide us and make us worthy of the sacrifices from which we have benefited. We pray we will never forget how blessed we truly are as a nation, as a people, and as your children. May you continue to bless the United States of America. And now, my sisters and brothers in Christ, may the blessings of Almighty God be upon you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And may our families be comforted in your name. Let us go forth in the name of peace to love and serve the Lord. Amen.
Please remain standing while we pay our respects to the colors as they exit. This concludes today's ceremony, but as we go home to our loved ones on this Memorial Day, I would like you to keep our veterans in our community and across the world in your hearts, thoughts, and prayers, whether they are currently serving or have gotten out of the service and are facing, you know, injuries or illnesses. For them, the veterans, we owe them everything. Let them never forget their sacrifice to this great nation and our freedoms and our countries. God bless the fallen, our troops, and their families. Thank you so much.